Hello, my dear students. Good morning to you all. Have you ever visited New Delhi? If you have, you must have watched the Amar Jawan Jyoti or the flame of the immortal soldiers who died defending their country. Yes, isn't it? There is Amar Jawan Jyoti at India Gate, New Delhi, right? This flame is a symbol for the soldiers who have sacrificed their life for their country. Now, the soldiers, sailors, and airmen of our armed forces, they deserve utmost respect, because they give their own personal comforts to give us freedom and protection from dangerous and sinful elements. These men and women give their today for our tomorrow. So today we are going to start with a poem, "Home They Brought No Warrior Dead," which is written by Alfred Tennyson. So, first let us talk about the poet Alfred Tennyson. Alfred Lord Tennyson was a very famous British poet. He was born on 6th August 1809 in England. He was the poet laureate of Great Britain and Ireland during the reign of Queen Victoria. He started writing poetry at the age of 8. He had a very unstable childhood. These uneven experiences brought variety in his poetry. He remains one of the most popular poets even today. His famous poems include "Break, Break, Break," "The Charge of the Light Brigade," "Tears," "Idle Tears," and "Crossing the Bar." Now, before starting with the poem "Home They Brought the Warrior Dead," imagine the family members of our soldiers who are assigned duties on the borders of India. How do these family members feel? What trauma do they undergo when they receive the news about the sudden demise of their loved ones? So let us understand the feelings of these family members in the poem "Home They Brought Her Warrior Dead." "Home They Brought Her Warrior Dead" is a very sensitive poem. It is a sad poem depicting the ill fate of our typical soldier's family. It depicts the feelings of warrior's wife, who was eagerly awaiting the arrival of her husband who went to the battlefield. Instead of the arrival of the husband, his dead body was brought home. The wife of the warrior was frozen with shock. She neither cried nor lost consciousness. All her maidens were worried about her. They said within themselves, "She must cry or she would die." So let's get started with the first stanza. "Home they brought her warrior dead. She nor swooned nor uttered cry. All her maidens watching said, 'She must weep or she will die.'" So swooned means lost consciousness or fainting. Maidens means female helpers here. A Now, in this first stanza, the speaker describes the reaction of a woman when her husband, who was a warrior who succumbed in the battlefield, has been brought back to home dead. And as a result, she did not faint or swoon or make any noise. She did not cry. Why? Because all of a sudden, the shock of her husband's death, the trauma, the grief made her feel extremely sad, and she was grief-stricken that she turned into a stone and there was no reaction. Her maidens, those who were gathered around her, watched her. They saw that she did not react at the death of her husband. They became worried. They were shocked. Now, why were these onlookers shocked at the response of the warrior's wife? Because the wife of this deceased soldier did not shed a single tear. So these maidens, they thought that if this situation continues and she remains like a stone for a long time, it will be very harmful for her because she did not express herself on the death of her husband. She did not grieve properly. They thought she might die if she did not weep, if she did not cry. The pain which she refused to let out would eventually kill her. Now let us see the rhyme scheme of the first stanza. Rhyming words dead and sad. So A, cry, die, B. So the rhyme scheme of the first stanza is A, B. Okay. Now let us move to the next stanza, second stanza of the poem. Then they praised him soft and low, called him worthy to be loved, truest friend and noblest foe, yet she neither spoke nor moved. Now here worthy. Worthy means deserving respect. Foe means enemy. Now, visualizing the condition, seeing the condition of the lady, the people around the dead soldier started praising him. They started praising the dead soldier. They talked about his life. They talked about the good things he did. They called him worthy to be loved. And they talked about the kind of friend he was. He was a very true friend. And he was even noble, honorable enemy. So as an enemy also, he was very noble. Now why they did all these things? Why they started praising the soldier? They did all this to evoke the emotions of his wife. So these emotions may lit her inner feelings and maybe she would cry. So to make her cry, they started praising him. But after doing all these things also, the wife of a dead soldier did not speak or move. Still, she was like a statue, like a stone. Now here also the rhyming words low, foe. So that is A, loved, moved, that is B. So rank scheme is AB, AB. Now let's begin with third stanza. Stole a maiden from her place, lightly to the warrior stepped. Took the face cloth from the face, yet she neither moved nor wept. Stole. What do you mean by stole? Stole means moved quietly. So a maiden, as we have already learned in first two stanzas, she has lost her husband who was a warrior and she did not weep, right? So the maidens tried to make her weep, but yet she did not weep. So now what they did, the young woman, she refused to weep or she refused to grieve, and so the maiden who were present over there, from that one of the maiden, she stood up, she moved quietly from her place and went to the dead soldier and she removed the cloth which was on his face. Now why the woman did so? Because she thought that if his wife would see the face of the dead husband, she would recollect all her memories and then she would weep. The lady was in a deep shock and so she was not able to weep, she was not able to grieve. And so the people around her, the maidens around her, were worried about her, because if she would not weep, what would happen? She would die. And so one of the maiden, she removed the face cloth from his face. Now in this stanza, what is the rhyme scheme? Now see the rhyming words: place, face. So this is A, and stepped, wept. Now what do you mean by stepped? Stepped means moved up, or you can say walk, it is Old English, okay? So moved up to, that is stepped. So she moved up to whom? Up to the dead soldier, okay? Now let us see the figure of speech in this stanza. So took the face cloth from the face. So you can see here, first sound is repeated. So when the beginning sound is repeated, the figure of speech is alliteration. So we have alliteration in this stanza. Let's move ahead. We'll begin with the fourth stanza. Rose, a nurse of 90 years, set his child upon her knee. Like summer tempest came her tears, sweet my child, I live for thee. Now tempest. Tempest means thunderstorm. Thee, it is Old English, that means you. Thee means you. At last. Now many other people, maidens, failed to make her cry. So at last what happened? A old nurse, she was of 90 years age. So she got up from her place. She was a very experienced nurse. And so what she did? She brought her child and she kept that child on her lap. Like summer tempest came her tears, sweet my child, I live for thee. Now here, what does her action tell us about? The action of the old nurse tells us that she wanted the widow to realize that she still had a reason to continue living. Now see, she was very much shocked and she thought that everything was finished and she did not weep. But now this old lady, she wanted to make her realize that she still had a child to look upon. And so she brought the child and kept the child on her lap. So after the child was kept on the lap, what happened? The lady burst into uncontrollable tears. The tears came rolling down like a summer tempest. Now see, after summer, what happens? The rain showers heavily, isn't it? So similarly, her tears came down, rolling down her cheeks heavily. So her tears are compared to the summer tempest. So here the figure of speech is simile. In this line, the figure of speech is simile. Why it is simile? Because the tears of the lady are compared to the summer tempest. Now she could not control her tears. So the tears came down very heavily like a thunderstorm. And so her tears are compared to summer tempest. The old experienced nurse, she was now successful in making her cry. Other maidens tried, but they were not successful. And at last, now this old lady, she was successful in making her cry. She had suppressed her pain so much that it poured out all at once. Now, since the beginning, since the dead body was brought, the woman, the soldier's wife, she had suppressed all her feelings within her. But now, all that feeling burst out and she cried. It all poured like a thunder storm. She cried out, "My sweet child, I live for thee." Now she cried that, "My sweet child, I have to live for you." Now see, she was very hopeless about the life ahead without her husband. After her husband's death, she was very hopeless. But now she wishes it to make meaningful for her child. Now she wanted to live for her child. And so she cried and she said that, "Sweet my child, I live for thee." Means I want to live for you. I want to bring you up. I want to nurture you. Isn't it? So see how the mother is. Try to understand the feelings of a mother. When she saw her child, all her tears burst like a thunderstorm. In this last stanza, why do you think the poet has chosen the old nurse for this action? The nurse, she is old and she is wise. And she is in the last years of her life. See, she is 90 years, isn't it? So she is in the last years of her life. And on the other hand, the child has just been born. The child is very infant, just been born. So the poet showcases the life cycle and how it moves along. Now what do you think? What is the theme of the poem? The theme of the poem is that a person in grief must weep, otherwise that person will die. See, if a person is in grief, he must weep or cry or to leave their life for the beloved ones. Okay? They have to leave their life ahead for the beloved ones who are there along with them. Okay? How can you tell that the poem is about deep and suppressed grief? How you can say that it is a sad poem? Now here, the poem deals with death of a soldier. His widow is surrounded by an atmosphere of sorrow and pain. Countless war widows undergo similar loss and grief. The widow is unable to cry due to shock and continues to suppress her grief till she cannot take it anymore. Now, the soldiers. Not only the soldiers, but also their families sacrifice. So, do you agree with this? Yes. The soldiers' families suffer a great deal. A mother loses her child. The son loses his father. Wife loses her husband. So, in this way, they also sacrifice. This causes a complete upheaval in the lives of family members. The soldiers and their family pay for the freedom of the country. Now, here you must have seen in the last stanza that the mother cries for the child, for the sake of her child. So, do you feel that mother's life is totally dedicated to their children? Yes, of course. A mother's life is totally dedicated to her children. As you can see in the poem, the widow chooses to live only because of her child. Similarly, any mother would do almost anything for her children. She loves them very much. From nurturing her children from her womb to the outside world, a mother shares special bond with her children. I hope you have understood this poem, Home They Brought Her, Warrior Red. Thank you.